everyone. This is Roger Muntu from Voice of America and RM Show. It's great to have you guys listening to us again tonight. This week, we're talking about a subject that's really important. And as we say since Monday, every day is a great day to celebrate the amazing women in our lives. But International Women, which happens on Monday, it's actually an extra reason for all of us to do so. Celebrated every year on the same date, on March 8th. The holiday encourages all people all around the world to actively choose, to celebrate women's achievements, raise awareness about women's equality, lobby for accelerated gender parity, and fundraise for like female-focused charities all over the world in Africa, particularly. According to the the United Nations, that day is celebrated all over the world. The holiday first came about in the early 90s. In 1908, women had begun actually agitating for a greater equality and for less oppressive working conditions, with 15,000 women taking to the street in New York City, demanding shorter hours, better pay, and voting rights. The first National Women's Day, as I was saying, was celebrated in 1909, Women's Day were actually marked in various countries for the next 100 years. Can you imagine that? But anyway, we continue discussing this in the RM Show and my shows. You're listening to us all over the world, in Anglophone country. My friends listening to me in Accra, in Ghana, in Tema. The friends listening to us in Harare, in Zambia. I want to welcome you again tonight, listening to the RM Show as you do every week. So my guest tonight is Priscilla Bonsu. Priscilla is actually reaching us from New York. I was telling you guys about New York City. That's where it all started. What a great, actually, Priscilla, to have you in the city where all that movement started. Priscilla, how you doing?
Hi, Roger. Thank you so much for having me. I hope you're doing well as well.
I'm doing well. It's how you guys doing in New York before I actually go on and on?
Yes. So the situation in New York is still very interesting. So things are still getting better. People are now eating outside. Luckily, it is getting there. So it's still a work in progress. It's not perfect yet, but things are definitely getting better.
Well, that's all we can hope for. Well, Priscilla, I'm glad you actually given us your time. Let me remind everybody that you are a legal analyst, and most of the time you participated as a foreign legal analyst. So you are definitely the perfect person to be our guest. And thank you for the time you've given us. And I know, given all these times, it's a crazy time to actually even having interviews and while you're busy doing other things. So I'm going to just jump to what we're discussing today. We are talking about this International Women's Day, and I was just introducing it. Would you please tell us a little bit, what's your views about Women's Day?
Yes, so I think that the International Women's Day is important to have. It's important to have at least one day of the year, which kind of reminds all of us, the whole world, of a woman's efforts and also the challenges that she faces on a daily basis. However, I do believe that this should actually be kept in mind at all times and actually every single day, in order to actually change the situation of women for the better.
Well, I hear you, Priscilla. So, but since we start talking about this week in the RM Show, my guests are naming so many women who have impacted, the world today. Do you have some names that you can actually tell us, some women who actually impacted you or that you look up to?
Well, there are countless women throughout history who have had a positive impact on the world. But if we focus on this year's a theme for International Women's Day, which is related to the COVID-19 pandemic, there are quite a few women that actually come to mind, particularly female leaders who have shown a lot of strength and tenacity in the fight against a COVID-19. For example, I think of Kamala Harris, who became the first female US vice president. I think of the German Chancellor Angela Merkel, for example, or Dr. Konjo Iweala, who is now the head of the World Trade Organization. Another person would be New Zealand's Prime Minister, Jacinda Ardern, and also Christine Lagarde, who is currently the president of the European Central Bank. But again, there are definitely so many more other female leaders that actually deserve to be mentioned here.
I couldn't agree more. I couldn't agree more. Now, you named these, you named all these women that I really respect greatly for all the achievements as well. According to the UN, Priscilla, this year's theme for the International Day, Women in Leadership, achieving an equal future in a COVID-19 world, celebrated the tremendous efforts by women and girls around the world in shaping a more equal future and recovery, from the COVID-19 pandemic. What are, your views on the impact of women during this pandemic? And we all know everybody will involve, and but what's your personal impact? I mean, your personal view.
Well, the pandemic certainly continues to shine light on the already existing inequalities between men and women. For example, women's jobs and livelihoods are on average much more vulnerable than those of men, as data shows that female job loss rates due to COVID-19 are actually twice as high as male job loss rates globally. And data also shows that female jobs are 19% more at risk than male jobs, simply because women are disproportionately represented in sectors that are more negatively affected by the COVID-19 crisis. So ultimately, women have had to put up with more problems during the COVID-19 pandemic than they actually had to deal with before the COVID-19 pandemic.
I'm going to end with my last question here because I know you have to go. What are today, because I'm sorry, got a little cough, but as I'm talking to some other guests on my shows, some of them are really not too excited about this day, about the International Women's Day, but of course they're also the other side where other people are coming to argue that, there are still some challenges that women are going through today. So that day is really, really important to keep on, raising awareness, as I was saying. What do you think that there are other challenges that women actually are experimenting or are facing today?
Well, in terms of gender equality, we still have a very long way to go. In fact, since the outbreak of COVID-19, data shows that violence against women and girls, particularly domestic violence, has actually intensified. This requires a global collective effort to stop such violence, and everyone has a role to play in it. We are also still dealing with the classic issue of the gender pay gap. As women are still being paid much less than men for the same exact kind of work. And another area worth mentioning is the fact that employers have to become more flexible in the workplace. Women are now able to work from home, but my concern is that once the pandemic is over, employers will fall back into old patterns and actually require a physical presence at the office at all times.
Well, that's what we're going to keep on watching and keep on following that as women keep celebrating this whole month. It's actually the whole month, isn't that right?
It's the whole month, yes. International Women's Month,
And
yes.
if you don't mind, Priscilla, we'll bring you back again to our station, to this show, to talk about more and more because it's a whole month. We need to celebrate our sisters, our mother, our wives, right?
Exactly. I'd love that.
Well, Priscilla, let me remind again, Priscilla Bansu is a foreign analyst, legal analyst in New York City. Thank you so much for giving us your time, and we talk to you next time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Take care.
You too.
Bye-bye.